On our continued discussion of quantum body, the new science of living a longer, healthier, and more vital life, I would like to share some more insights into the nature of quantum body and how you owe your existence to quantum entanglement right from the beginning of your existence in this world. From the time you were a fertilized egg to the time you became a baby, and then all the way through right now, every experience is a result of quantum entanglement and phenomena associated with quantum entanglement. There's growing evidence that morphogenesis and differentiation from a fertilized egg to the development of a baby could be quantum phenomena linked to epigenetic activity. So what is morphogenesis and differentiation? It is the journey from a fertilized egg, single cell, that divides itself, becomes 2, becomes 4, becomes 8, ultimately 50 trillion cells, more than all the stars in the Milky Way galaxy, where every cell is cooperating with every cell instantly to regulate your body, what we call self-regulation and homeostasis. But let's start from the beginning. Morphogenesis is the process by which the fertilized egg develops into a complete organism with a variety of different cell types and tissues. It is a highly regulated process that is controlled by a number of different factors, including genes, proteins, and hormones. Epigenetic activity is the process by which gene expression is regulated without changing the DNA sequence itself. This can be done through a variety of mechanisms such as DNA methylation, histone modification, and non-coding RNAs, ribonucleic acids. Quantum phenomena are phenomena that cannot be explained by classical physics, but can be explained by the principles of quantum mechanics. Some examples of quantum mechanics include entanglement, superposition, and tunneling, or what we call quantum leaps. There are a number of different ways in which quantum phenomena could be involved in morphogenesis and differentiation. For example, quantum entanglement could allow different parts of the developing embryo to communicate with each other and coordinate their growth and development. Quantum superposition could allow cells to explore different development pathways before committing to one. And quantum tunneling could allow cells to overcome energy barriers and differentiate into new cell types. Epigenetic activity could also play a role in quantum morphogenesis and differentiation. For example, DNA methylation could be used to control the entanglement of different DNA sequences. Histone modification could be used to control the superposition of different gene expression states, and non-coding RNAs could be used to control quantum tunneling. So there are other examples of quantum phenomena in biology. A study published in the journal Physical Biology in 2015 found that entanglement of DNA sequences can play a role in gene expression. A study published in the journal Frontiers in Genetics in 2017 found that histone modification can control the superposition of gene expression states. A study published in the journal Nature Communication in 2019 found that non-coding RNAs can control quantum tunneling. So that's from fertilized egg to baby. Now, what about after that? Well, how does your body do all these trillions of things? Every cell is doing trillions of things, and every cell is instantly correlating its activity with all other cells in the body. So your biology is a result of quantum entanglement. There's no or non-local correlation. And furthermore, your biology is entangled with cosmic rhythms, seasonal rhythms, gravitational rhythms, lunar rhythms, and of course, circadian rhythms. This is all one process, one organism, which is the entire universe. You know, this non-local correlation or quantum entanglement was called spooky action at a distance by Einstein. He and Niels Bohr collided over very many concepts, but this was one, because Niels Bohr thought that consciousness is fundamental reality, and Einstein was a so-called realist. And even though he described relativity and played a role in the development of quantum mechanics, he was troubled by the counterintuitive aspects of quantum mechanics. David Bohm had a good analogy for this spooky action at a distance. He said, imagine a fish in a fish tank, and you can only see the head and the tail because the rest of the vision is blocked because some parts of the fish tank are not seen through, let's say, your perceptual apparatus. So every time the head moves, the tail moves, and you can't see what's happening in between. So you think there's spooky action at a distance, but actually it's all one organism functioning as a whole. And so the fish is a good analogy for your body. When your head moves, everything else in the body moves. So when your arm moves, everything else in the body moves simultaneously. All the cells are involved in a single motor activity and a single perceptual activity also. Everything corresponds to everything else. So that fish, your body, all living organisms, and everything that we call an ecosystem and the universe are one unified process. Think of the universe as the body of the fundamental consciousness, God, pure consciousness, Allah, Ein Sof, Brahman, doesn't matter. But think of this cosmos, a living organism, and you are a holographic or a holo movement as part of that, not even a part, as a active movement of the whole universe. You and the universe are one. And understanding quantum entanglement, quantum biology, quantum body, morphogenesis and differentiation gives us a clue to the mechanics of self-regulation and homeostasis, which we call health and longevity. Please share your thoughts with me and give me your feedback.